Welcome back to AfricaCom TV. We're coming to you live, of course, from AfricaCom 2019, the largest gathering of its kind, where we're accelerating enterprise digital transformation in Africa. Joining me now is Sanjay Nayak. He is the CEO and Managing Director of Tejas Networks. Sanjay, lovely to have you at AfricaCom TV. Introduce us to Tejas Networks. What is it that you guys do?
So Tejas Networks is a very innovative company, and if you think about, and we are from India and of course going global now, so think about, everybody in the world talks about India as being a software powerhouse. So Tejas Networks is the first deep technology company from India which actually went from being a startup to a listed company. And what Tejas does very unique in the world is something which is extremely relevant for Africa in particular. And let me tell you what we do. So we essentially build telecom equipment which allows you to build a broadband network, whether it is on a technology like fiber, on GPON or Ethernet, or on wireless using LTE and 5G, and then taking all that traffic and accumulating it into the metros and the core of the network. So essentially, we build equipment which starts from megabits and goes through terabits of capacity. And this is really what is extremely exciting, because Africa is going through a digital transformation, and the experience we've had in a country like India, which has very similar dynamics in terms of population, affordability, environmental conditions. We believe that being extremely successful in India, and we are the largest in India in terms of this kind of technology, bringing it to Africa is extremely exciting.
So what differentiates you? What sets you apart from your competition?
So two different things which we think we would like to talk about. One is on the technology front. So on the technology front, if you think how networks were built about 10 or 15 years back, they're all about hardware. You know, you had a bunch of hardware and there was a little bit of software running. If you fast forward today, and if you're going to look at a network that you're building today for the next 10 years, it's all about great hardware, but really differentiated software. And using our DNA from India, which is software, we have our products differentiated by what we call software-defined hardware. And what that does is, you can buy a piece of hardware today, it performs a network function A today, and then you can continue to upgrade to network function B and C and D, higher capacity, new services, and that's one thing which you do on the technology. So it's a very flexible technology, and it's more like a Swiss Army knife, if you were to think of, where an operator, for example, wants to give a new service, a new broadband service to a community or a city in an underserved area. So you can start with the wireless, because that's the fastest way to reach, using the latest LTE and 5G when it happens. And second, as and when he can lay fiber, he can give fiber to the home, which is the right thing to do. All of that can happen with a box like this, which is just one single piece of hardware, and you can continue to upgrade. That's just one example. The second thing which I would like to say on the business side of things. Today, most of the equipment in the world, the way it used to be traditionally done, it was designed in the US or Europe, and they certainly had great technology, but their target customers, the affordability levels were very different than what Africa has. Now, look at it from our perspective. In India, we want to have the latest technology, because most of the equipment in the world in telecom, half of the R&D is out of Bangalore, which is the city where our company is headquartered. So we have the DNA of the world's best technology. So we bring the latest technology, but at the most affordable prices, because India, by the way, is the lowest cost telecom service market in the world. So being successful to be able to bridge the latest technology with most competitive prices, and there's a third dimension, which is equally important for India and Africa, which is quality. The problem in a country like Africa is that reaching sites is very difficult. The operating costs are very, very high. So while you may get a cheap capex on day one, if your operations are going to be very high, it's going to be very tough. So our equipment is of the highest quality, ruggedized in very poor conditions of power, fiber cards, dust environment, low skill set of people to maintain, and we make that work. And just give you a few examples. Recently we rolled out the world's largest rural broadband network in India. 250,000 villages covering 300,000 kilometers of fiber done on our equipment, and it's working. This is the backbone of digital India. So having the experience of that network, when we come to Africa, latest technology, most competitive prices, and highest quality. That's something which we are finding, our customers are really enjoying it in Africa.
And I imagine you launching those two products earlier in 2019, pertaining to optical and broadband access space, it's going to help you achieve even more.
Absolutely. So the two products that we launched this year are, again, I would say, having a tremendous impact. One is what we call is the ultra-converged access platform. This is the Swiss Army knife of access. So anybody who wants to give a broadband services starts off with this, and pretty much it scales everything that you need to offer broadband. This was launched at the Mobile World Congress. It's been getting tremendous traction. In fact, since morning, literally, we've been having nonstop traffic at our booth. At the other extreme end is this product, which is the world's highest capacity switch. It's 48 terabits of capacity, and it's a pay-as-you-grow model. So you can start with as small a capacity over there, and then you can scale it up to this one. So these are just the innovations which kind of give you the fact that we have the emerging market mindset of building products. We build products which are relevant for this market, and that's what is getting us success.
You are growing quite rapidly in Africa and other emerging markets. What opportunities, suppose, are waiting for Tejas networks in those markets? And more importantly, how do the customers ultimately benefit from your technology?
Absolutely. It's a very good question. So there are really, when you talk to a customer here, there are a few things that they're looking at. Number one, they're looking at the latest technology because they don't want to be building anything which is obsolete. They want to build the stuff with the latest stuff. And they want to be future-proof in a way because technology keeps changing. So I think that's the number one assurance that they need. And with our software-defined hardware architecture, by definition, it's like a mobile phone. You buy the phone on day one, and you keep upgrading your apps, and you really get new services. So I think with our product, they get the benefit of that kind of a thing on the optical transmission and the, you know, the broadband infrastructure. So that's one thing they're looking at. The second thing they're looking at, which I'm very concerned about in a country like Africa, but I'm happy that they're looking at, is the quality of service, the relationships. They want to have partners whom they can trust. So we had dinner with one of the largest operators in this part of the world with their CEO last night, and he said, the best thing I like about Tejas is your quality of service. The companies in Africa are not, you know, $100 billion in size, but they do need similar attention. So working with those people and giving them the attention of service is the second thing they look at. And the third thing people look at is, of course, competitiveness in terms of both operating cost as well as the capital. So I think we provide all the three. And what we're also putting is a lot more investments on the ground. So we actually have local partnership with Seco, which is one of the very reputed companies and a BE enterprise in South Africa. About 5 years back, we just have one office in Africa. Now we have our own offices with field support in South Africa, East Africa, West Africa, North Africa, and we continue to expand. So really having more feet on the ground, localizing the skill sets, training local people, making the local investments, I think those are all things that you're doing.
Well, I wish you a very successful AfricaCom 2019. Thank you very much to
Thank
the
you.
CEO
nice talking to you.
And the Managing Director of Tejas Networks, that's Sanjay Nayak.